Hello friends, today we will study about DVT, that is deep vein thrombosis, venous thrombosis. The etiology involved in this venous thrombosis are stasis, injury to vessel wall and hypercoagulability of blood. This is the etiology of venous thrombosis. What are the predisposing factors for venous thrombosis? We have major injuries following any operations, visceral cancers, tobacco smoking, any comorbidities like diabetes or congestive heart failure, polycythemia vera and prolonged bed rest, pregnancy, varicose vein, obesity. These are the predisposing factors for venous thrombosis. What is the effect of this thrombosis? Proximally, this thrombosis can extend into larger vein. It can cause pulmonary embolism or infarction. Proximally, this thrombosis can extend into larger vein. It can go into pulmonary veins, causing pulmonary embolism or infarction. Whereas, locally, the clot can organize into fibrous tissue, so that the venous valves are destroyed. It can cause chronic venous valvular insufficiency and it can also cause calcification, causing phlebolith. And distally, this thrombosis can cause venous obstruction, which leads to increase in distal venous pressure, causing edema. It causes edema. Types of venous thrombosis are superficial vein thrombosis and deep vein thrombosis. One is superficial and one more is deep venous thrombosis. This superficial venous thrombosis is also called as thrombophlebitis. Thrombophlebitis. In this, superficial veins are involved. Usually it can be seen in varicose veins or after any IV infusion. This thrombophlebitis involves the superficial veins of lower limb. It can be associated with acute inflammatory response like pain, swelling, redness and tenderness. Next one is deep venous thrombosis. It is also called as phlebothrombosis. In this session, we will study in detail about deep venous thrombosis. In this picture, we can see the case of DVT, that is, we can see swelling of the lower limb. DVT, that is deep venous thrombosis. Here also etiology remains the same, that is stasis, increased blood coagulability and injury to vessel wall. Usually it is seen more common after operations or immobility for a considerable period, and it can be seen after childbirth or any local trauma. What are the clinical features of DVT? Usually patients with DVT remain asymptomatic. If at all, if any symptoms are present, means the most common symptom is pain. That is, patient will be having aching type of pain. And sometimes patient can present with swelling of the lower limb. And this aching pain is aggravated by muscular activity at the site of thrombosis. What are the signs? We will see swelling and tenderness. There are two signs called as Hohmann sign and Moses sign. Hohmann sign and Moses sign. What are these signs? Hohmann sign means forceful dorsiflexion of the foot with knee extended will elicit pain in the calf region. That means forceful dorsiflexion of the foot causes pain in the calf region. This indicates the DVT. And one more is Moses sign. This means squeezing of the calf muscle causes pain. In this, there is squeezing which causes the pain in calf region. In this, there is forceful dorsiflexion at foot which causes the pain in calf region. But this test should not be done as it may cause dislodgement of the emboli, causing pulmonary embolism. So this test should not be done. What are the special investigations apart from normal routine investigations? We have phlebography. phlebography. In this investigation, we will inject a dye, that is, we will inject 45% sodium diatriazoate. Sodium diatriazoate. We will inject this dye into a vein on the dorsum of great toe. When the veins are filled with dye, films are taken in two planes. In this phlebography, the films are taken in two planes. Next one is radioactive fibrinogen test. These are the special investigations done in DVT. Radioactive fibrinogen test. And we have Doppler study. In this Doppler study, the distorted flow pattern and absence of flow in large veins can be seen. Next one is plethysmography. This plethysmography quantifies the venous obstruction. We can measure the venous pressure. Venous pressure measurement. We can do duplex scan. This duplex scan is the best investigation due to direct visualization of the structures. In this duplex scan, we can obtain both functional and anatomical information about the veins and obstructions. How to prevent this DVT? Prevention of DVT. What are the principles involved in this prevention? We should minimize the venous stasis and we should avoid the venous intimal injury and we should reduce the hypercoagulability of blood. Prevention must begin before the operation. Prevention for DVT has to be started before the operation. We have prevention before operation, during operation and after operation. How to prevent DVT before operation? What are the measures? Time spent in the hospital awaiting operation should be less and we can advise for leg elevation above the heart level. And what are the measures during the operation? Elevation of leg during the operation if possible and hypertonic IV solutions should not be infused in veins of lower limb. We can give intermittent pneumatic compression or electrical calf stimulation and active plantar flexion of the feet which effectively prevent the venous stasis in the soleal veins. And use of anticoagulants like heparin in small dose. It is usually introduced subcutaneously 2 hours prior to the operation and every 8th hourly after the surgery for 7 days. After operation, we can prescribe aspirin in a small dose and we can prescribe elastic stockings compress the superficial veins, which in turn increases the velocity of venous blood flow through the deep veins, that reduces the venous stasis. And we can advise for leg elevation above the heart level. Treatment of DVT, we have conservative management and operative management. First one is bed rest. Thrombi gets adherent to vein wall, which decreases the dislodgement of thrombi, so it prevents the pulmonary embolism. And limb elevation relieves the pain and edema. It also prevents the venous stasis. We can prescribe elastic stockings. And standing and sitting should be avoided. Patient can walk, but standing and sitting should be avoided. Next one is we can prescribe heparin at least for 7 days. Next one is we can prescribe coumarin derivatives and fibrinolytic drugs like streptokinase. These fibrinolytic drugs lyse the clots in the deep veins. What are the operative procedures in treatment of DVT? Operative procedures. We can do bypass procedure. Bypass with vein or prosthetic material. Usually it is done in larger veins like vena cava or iliac vein. Next one is valvular repair. If the valves are damaged, it can be repaired. There are again two types of valves repair. That is internal by incising and open the vein and suture, or externally valves are sutured from the outside the vein. In external type, we don't open the vein, whereas in internal type, we incise the vein and open it and suture it. Third one is valve transplant by autograft. Usually, we will use axillary or brachial vein from the same person, that is autograft. What are the other procedures done in DVT? We have venous thrombectomy with Fogarty catheter. Venous thrombectomy with Fogarty catheter. If patient presents with gangrene, that means it is surgical emergency, so it should be treated immediately by opening the femoral vein at inguinal region, and we should remove the all clots. That is open surgery, and we can ligate the vessels, like we can ligate the femoral vein or iliac vein. Next one is interruption of venous pathway to lungs by narrowing the inferior vena cava using sutures or serrated clips, or we can use filters. By this method, we can interrupt the venous pathway to lungs by narrowing the inferior vena cava using sutures, serrated clips and filters. So this is about the deep venous thrombosis. In this session, we have discussed about venous thrombosis, which has two types: superficial venous thrombosis and deep venous thrombosis. Friends, if you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends, and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you.